different parts, so if you were to go this way, and we look to see what happens to the body, right? We look at it and manipulate it. See if I touch another point there, you move that little bit. Everything's a little tiny movement, so you won't see the leg movement.
The ability to
be really small. Mm-hmm. So grab my wrist and move it to a point where you feel it's going to move me 2 inches. Right? You see me move?
That's a good lever. You're going to have to get used to it, because
like
this
that,
is normal.
Right?
Because 90% of the time, this is going to work the most.
Yeah.
Okay?
So
does this make sense?
So here's a pivot point.
What's the difference between
pivot point
me doing back like this versus me twisting and then going back?
So look for
you feel how the spine locks are different?
There's one, yeah.
I mean, there's a huge difference.
The other one.
You have a wider range.
Mm-hmm.
You have wider range of movement.
You're not trying to memorize them all.
You have a
just
shorter
look at the structure.
Range of movement.
So you picture me.
See how the spine locked in?
As a stick.
As
so
opposed
look, look like
to
a
this.
Stick figure. So stick
if
figure
I go ahead and I work this like so,
here,
versus
here.
Locking it in and working like
these
so.
Are stick figures. Cross the waist.
This is stick. Shorter range of motion.
So it's here.
So if
here.
I'm going right here.
And the legs.
So from here to here.
So don't look at the muscle mass. Don't look at
the body itself.
Just look at the sticks. So when
what?
I see
what?
When I see this, I look at I see this as a stick.
Does that make sense?
David. So if I move this
it
way,
is.
In this way,
so
this
just
way,
like I'm doing with this, click, click,
like
click,
this.
Click, click, locking
here,
in.
Here,
right? I'm doing the same thing over here.
Right? Right?
Click, 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 locked
and
in.
And we're not using
all the way to the ground.
For
right?
Strength.
So if I go ahead
push
and
down.
Squat,
we're just squatting a little bit.
Right now.
Okay. You imagine.
So, try to live on. And reason
right?
For going all the way around.
Well, if I just lean on
this,
same thing as you're trying to lift me. You do it.
For me.
So.
Yes.
Is it?
Follow. So a lot of this is,
well, sorry,
movement
no,
is going to make
saying, is this a bad position?
It's a lot of following.
If I go ahead and lock it in right here, lock this one in right here, and then
bring you down when you hit the ground,
is this a bad position?
No.
So point is to work from every possible little
angle. A lot of this is with breathing.
That's why I'm going
every time you hear, I feel an impact.
Okay, so... in a real scenario, you may end up like this.
Right?
So this
you
is bad.
Impact
no.
Here.
Keep working. Okay. Make sense?
Breathe out. I also breathe
so
out when I'm
here.
So breathing.
Same through. Thing up here.
Okay. So, for instance, here, grab my hand, and you were to just squat, right? And then I fall. So do it a little bit harder, and then I fall. Right?
Yeah.
You gotta let go, though, otherwise you'll go down with it, right?
You see how it's all flowing?
Mm-hmm.
So look for all the points. Walk around the body and look for these points.
Okay, so you said
elbow
first. One here.
Just don't try to remember. Just see what happens when you
it's
all right.
Just let me know so that I'm aware. Here, I'm going to push on the eyebrows. In a real scenario.
Yeah,
did
one.
You finish your series?
I did.
You passed it. Congratulations.
If I'm going straight up and then down.
Yeah.
Same thing from the front.
Up
here.
Yep.
Same
now,
thing this way.
There's
nope.
Here. Right? Or
just like I did over there on the back.
Right.
It's crisscross.
And as you do
this
it,
way
on this.
Versus this way.
Yeah,
oh,
because
I need
what
a
was the reason
pivot.
Behind
I
this?
Lever.
Uh-huh. You need to have a pivot point and a forward.
We're going this way.
But I also have
this
to move
way.
2 inches. Right?
Or going
yep.
This way
exactly.
To this
so you
way.
Can imagine if you're leaning on there like that, and you just squat a little bit. See how now I can't stand up anymore. It's really that simple. Okay?
What am
and
I
then
doing?
There's the long stick, the backbone. Right? Goes all the way through. So for
spinal.
Instance, yeah. If you're a push here and here, you notice how you
if
really
I
want
have
to fall
a
back, right? Do that to me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right?
Same thing here if you lock it in and push. You see how that's a stick now, it's solid.
Mm-hmm.
Make sense?
Now
I'm pushing just about
squat.
The kneecap for a reason. There's another pressure.
Right? And we fall. Right? And when we fall, we breathe out.
If
we
I
breathe out.
Below the kneecap.
Ow.
Look for.
Well, the kneecap, as it sits there, just idling, if I push down,
right.
It tends to create a better lock.
Yeah.
If I push up here,
yeah.
Then the knee can go left or right.
Uh-huh. And then...
Knee kept exploding.
See so if you were to grab it here, maybe pull on there.
Do the same thing up here.
Oh, the knee?
Yeah. You see that?
What you're looking
here.
For is, again,
remember, there's
look
the
at my knee. Keep an eye on my knee
when
you're doing this.
Oh, okay.
And crisscross, right? Because there's a pivot point here and here.
Locked
right?
In at all.
Oh, that happened then.
Feel that? Like that, right?
Yeah, so like there's
this.
A lock. You should try pushing on this and see what happens. Try pushing and then
the
moving it left to right.
And then the opposite.
Now move it.
Oh, yeah. You see that?
The other.
Okay.
Yeah.
See what's happening.
Yeah.
So you're learning through this process.
Now look at the try to look at the big stick from here and then to the knee.
Yeah. Joystick.
See what happens.
Okay.
Right. See what happens to the body?
Mm-hmm.
Just kind of compresses. Yeah. Keep looking for more. There's never enough. There's tons of them.
Pivot point. So it's a lock.
Well, there would be one from here to the ankle, wouldn't there?
All
that
is
one all the way down.
See what happens.
You can go this.
This? I don't know.
Yeah. You're not going to be able to leg up. You're going to lose your balance,
way.
Right?
Just like
you always want to stay
if
balanced.
I'm going this way.
Okay,
so I can go this way.
Maybe.
Push on the fingers,
maybe.
That's one
right. Or
unless
or
it's like
I
this way.
Push
or
it in.
Or
pull on this arm, right?
Very
a little bit?
This way. You
want it
push
that way?
Right below these joints, right?
Now, what if you kick that out of it?
Oh, like
right
this?
Below the
right. You see how that reacts?
Yeah.
Okay, keep going right
yeah,
here. Create a locked pivot
right.
Point. So, when you're working, here, let's move over here. Jimmy, can you please move over there?
Uh-huh.
Here we go. So, camera. Go ahead and lock in. Lock in meaning, right here.
That's all I have for now.
Right.
And now
so,
you're pushing down?
We'll get them now in the sense where we talked okay. About before. We're
try not just pushing down, try to push down and then.
Bring them.
Nothing. What's happening?
Try to look for just.
Pull it in, twist it slightly,
gonna go
one way or the other. Well,
we have to
now push
work on a lock, right? This one.
Now push left, right.
Work on a lock, right? Is this going to work?
I don't
have to work
there.
On that much.
Yep.
Okay.
You're
that
seeing where you're losing.
See how effective that is?
Okay.
And then the teeter top.
Shoulders.
In the middle, you got a pivot point, right?
Hips.
Pivot point there, right? Pivot point there, like
still
that,
working
right?
From this
angle.
The shoulders.
Shoulder to
so
hip.
Did, obviously.
And
the
crisscross. So if you're pushing here, you want to be
so
right here,
imagine
pushing the other way.
This is
this
the lever, right?
In equal left.
Between here and here is the lever. Right? So if I'm just doing this part, it's not doing this.
Just there.
So I have
straight.
All the way here. See the big difference? The thumb, if I just
David,
do the thumb by
any input?
So if I start the lever from here to here.
I think you're doing great, Gal.
Oh, good.
Now,
good. Oh, me?
Yeah.
Oh,
both.
Okay, go ahead.
Both of
okay.
Them.
Okay, the med.
Straight up and down.
Yes.
Straight
now
up and down.
The
eyebrows? Yep.
Straight up and down.
Yep.
And then
with the nose.
There you go. Here's the difference.
It
doesn't do much.
Sorry.
A little bit more.
It
doesn't do much too, right?
Sorry.
That's a big difference.
Okay.
Does that make sense, though?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, you can really easily drop with no effort.
Now you might
this is what we're shooting for.
Right.
And then
forward toward your leg.
Hips.
My body move different?
Hips.
So
push one of the way. The
look
for the leg maybe.
Speed up fast, right?
Push it.
Walking with a drag back
right?
Push down?
Push down.
Yeah.
Let's try that.
No, above the kneecap. Remember?
Oh, keep going.
Push on
there
and squat.
Right? You can't stop.
Oh.
Okay. None of that.
We do that.
You may, but the problem is if you get into a real
here.
Conflict, yeah, you go like this, and they go ahead and pull you down and start. Because you can't afford to put the bigger guy, especially.
Right?
Be
like,
oh,
you can pull it down. Right? Right? The other side.
So for me, if I were to pick over here,
how would it?
In the fly by both.
So that
right.
I'm used to doing.
For strength.
This one, that one is. So would that work also for? It's. I mean, does it work in the same way as?
Instead of the small pivot point. Farther apart.
It's the same. Yeah, are you seeing? It's the same idea. Look, in order for me to drop you, let's say from here, right? I can bring you back.
You gotta have a
and then down, right?
In the fulcrum.
Or
right?
I can bring you forward and then down.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Is there a difference?
Right.
On the ground, right? But the idea, the structurally, if you take a look again, here, pull this back.
It depends always, right?
So back and at an angle. This way.
If I'm this thing, the power one.
Okay. Versus. Hold it right there.
This is a straight lever.
Oh,
step
right?
This
yeah.
way a little bit.
Now you can practice
keep
to fall.
My leg that way.
Now when you fall, I need to have your hand behind the back of your head.
Okay.
Step back
every
a little
time
bit.
Behind the head.
Take
hand
a look.
Behind back of the head. Doesn't matter which hand.
Same
just
thing.
One hand behind the back of the head.
Versus.
So without me doing anything, I want you to practice fall.
Same thing.
I'm
going to show you how to stay. Really.
What's the principle behind it? Because a lot of people,
like
David here, he was trying to, for
the
longest time, turn it into a move. And I don't want it to be a move because I'm trying to teach him
try.
I'm like
why
afraid
this
of like
how
falling,
it's okay.
I'm very
okay.
clumsy,
that's
so.
That's why we have to practice that a lot.
You said.
Goes back,
on your other foot.
Crisscross, head, shoulders, arms, try whatever.
Like
that's the kind of beauty for you.
I'm trying the grass.
You get a
working
yeah. mannequin. I'm not fighting you, I'm not resisting you. You just go ahead and.
Face down.
Go.
Turn around, face down.
Stick up.
Stick your foot out, sit on your foot. There you go, just like that.
No.
Now,
just
the impact, the boom, boom, boom.
So imagine a fight.
Breathing
yeah.
out.
You're punching me?
You gotta breathe out, heavily
yeah.
breathing
you're
out.
You're punching me?
Then it makes it soft.
I'm
right?
going ahead, and now
yeah.
I'm over here, right? I can work
I
from here
fall.
Right now, right?
Falling?
Or I can work from here right now. Or now I'm gonna all stop, right. and I'm running from here.
You can do that naturally.
Yeah,
okay.
Why would you have
so you were back here, and then you.
yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Keep going in a full circle.
Okay.
Keep moving in that way.
Try five.
Good.
You too.
Yep.
Here. Versus the other way. Crisscross.
Breathe out a lot.
Yep. Pull. Yep. Or the other way. Push. Can you push and pull?
Go slow
yep.
as you like. Go slow as you like. Used to
okay.
that,
more of your favorite. Since you're already here, go in straight, and then as you turn the arm.
Real slow, real slow, David. Show slow.
Are you seeing the difference?
Watch,
so if I'm going
slow,
in.
Watch. Who goes out? Sit on the other foot.
Makes sense.
All that air out. All the air out.
No, sorry. Trust me.
Start breathing the air out first.
This is like just a little bit.
Before you
okay.
start to
okay.
fall. It takes a lot of effort to get all that air out.
Mm-hmm. So you're doing the same stuff.
So you want to hear yourself breathe. Start breathing first. Yep.
You're the judge right now. You should be pushing harder on the thumb if you're pushing on it.
Observing when you fall. Twist your leg a little bit so you can keep it straight.
Yeah, you can do it like that too.
Yeah. So both
bottom line,
it's
two pivot points.
Forward,
makes sense?
Like this.
So either like this.
Who knows what you're going to do.
Twist your ankle or something. Twist your ankle.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I felt my twist.
It takes practice.
Now look down at your feet to see where they are.
Good. Cross. Base.
Like sitting down. You're just sitting down.
From here?
Yep. Do it super slow. Breathe out while you're doing it. You know, for your balance, keep your arms out too. Right.
Which sets you up. So if I was to go this way, what is this?
Almost. It just that you saw or you felt the muscles going.
Constantly.
Yeah,
full.
I have a weak ankle.
The other thing is when we're doing this, we're also working on just balancing the body. Look at me right now. Can you see any point of this balance that you can utilize?
So you have fewer movements.
Right now?
Sure.
No.
Other weight on that
foot. If I go ahead and, let's say, take an impact. Can you see? You see the difference?
No.
Okay, so what if I take an impact right here?
It's not
see, the body's not flying.
It's
So whatever happens as far as
squat is straight down like this.
We're making sure to compromise the body.
So when we squat, we're straightening
the hips,
squat straight down.
Drop, finish, eat,
move. Falling back.
5, 6, 10 attackers.
That was, I remember, when I used to fight. That was one of the things that I always felt. When I got here, I wouldn't be following into it, so a lot of times I just get stuck here.
Almost perfect.
Right. Versus,
versus actually.
You go through this for a little bit, then you'll see what I'm talking about. Because you got me right there,
yeah,
right?
So
and I already have this.
The one who falls the least or the most.
I already have this that I can work. I already have something that I'm coming up with. Does that make sense? I can already pick it out.
Hit the most.
I can see how many things are going on. It's not just one. So if I was to show you a move,
already done and they can't do anymore,
per se,
that's the one that
I'd be doing you a disservice. That makes sense.
You can still get up and down, up and down,
I mean,
up and
physically,
down. Physically, keep hitting.
If I put you up against
not,
David, for instance,
the person that lasts
in an open combat, chances are you're not going to win.
So
just because of the weight difference. If it's on moves. But if it's all in here,
and you're like,
David's taller. You're shorter. You have a lower center of gravity.
Actually,
this is huge.
You try doing
huge.
That.
So then if David gets compromised,
try to keep that forward and just, exactly. Okay. Now, go like
you're
sitting
have
down.
You fall.
Sit. Exactly. That's right.
There you go. Nice and smooth.
There's a point.
Shoulders.
The hand right. Behind the head.
Hips.
Because you don't know if you have.
Always hand behind the head. This concrete is softer. It sounds funny, but it's not. That stuff's got rocks.
Yeah.
So as you're coming in this way.
All right.
Okay.
So here, let's work on, you guys work on the 6 points together.
Yep.
And you're the basics on the 6 points. So you just start working on David's
the hips as you're doing that.
Those 6 points.
Just be careful of the thumb. I heard it.
Good job.
Your thumb.
All right. A little bit, one more thing that we forgot. That's this guy.
Try that. Take my hand and make it yours. So move it to you.
What you're doing
right,
is you're making sure is to keep this heel from slipping
now
out.
You cut it.
Yep. And
right.
Once it can't do that, then you're just applying it.
But because you have to think, you can rotate it a little bit. That's a little bit from this top.
Nice and slowly stand.
To
so look, I hooked you.
Because that gets you out of balance. So if I have your arm, for example, first of all,
good.
I get to
take it down a little.
Then if I want to get you down, I hold much of the other hand, put it down to here, and I squat to jump.
Okay, Jimmy, you already took him through falling?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I want to see, make sure that you probably went through this,
but
I want to know for sure that you fell.
I went down, but you didn't squat.
How did you fall? We don't just go We go down to 1 foot and off the heel. Fall down absolutely as relaxed as you can. We're just first gonna fall back.
Okay.
The only thing, stop.
What?
I want you to keep make sure and have a hand behind
your
head.
I don't know.
So you don't end up
I was like, wait, this is wrong.
Shut up.
I was like, wait, this does not look great.
Okay.
It took me a second to realize that. Okay, follow the style.
That's right. Set both legs down on the ground and relax.
I start breathing first.
Breathing out. Actually, hold on. Do me a favor. Jimmy, you want to work that with them too?
Right,
sure.
Breathing.
Oh, you did, all right. Okay. Take a cut. Take your hands, lock them in as hard as you can like this, okay? Now, take a deep breath, hold it, and then squat. Now, do the same thing, and as you're squatting, exhale, but proportionately. So, like this, and go. Notice the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Chest convulsed this way.
Well,
the air pocket doesn't allow
you
to move.
To go?
Okay.
Does that
so
make sense?
The,
so as you're falling down, if you're holding your breath, that's what's happening to you. Okay? So breathe out proportionately so it'd be more
like
a. Like
that.
This then?
Just relax, like, you know, like a pillow. Like this.
Where do you want me to go?
Legs out, all the way.
Different things.
Well, that's the way. Yeah. So get up, and then I want you that way after you've fallen down. More relaxed. Yeah, but you see this, because I mean, if you carry a firearm or anything like that,
no.
If you would, it would be pretty.
Convenient, let's say, especially if it's in a crowd. You get out of the line of fire, shoot simultaneously.
Well, do the same thing that you did over there.
Also,
some grass. Imagine it's grass, nice, comfortable,
cushy
grass,
but
you have to fall down grass.
Okay.
The same 6 points, but now we're going to start.
Breathe out when you do.
Make sense?
Okay.
So,
now you can't twist that leg.
No, it can't.
You have to fall down exactly straight.
Out, right?
Yeah.
Fall down exactly straight.
Stand behind the head. Good.
Don't box the head off.
Okay, let me show you.
Yeah.
So,
no, not at all.
Breathing out.
It's hurt a lot.
Same thing.
Yeah,
so
I
don't
feel
some brain.
Because it's pavement.
You're
going to
go bump to work
gonna
tomorrow.
You're going to have to go and collect it with a spoon and put it back in.
Yeah. You got it
all. Good. Just all the way to the ground then.
Yeah.
And relax.
Okay.
One more time.
So, pivot.
What I want you to do is, I want you to make sure you're not going to have your leg like this.
Okay, but now.
Because what's going to happen is, if it's going to slip, you're going to nail your knee. Anything that we do, falling, sliding,
that's going to be
moving
around,
rolling, lower level acrobatics, we try to avoid to use our, to hit our. Bones.
I know the 6 points.
Okay? So, for instance, if I fall down and I have my elbow like this, right, and I go, ooh, heel up. Boom. What if I fall down like that? Feel the bone.
It's not off balance.
Protective. Difference? Versus falling down like this or like this, right? Boom, bone, broken. Versus like this with a rotation. Muscles. Just muscles now at this point.
Right?
Make sense?
So the whole point is being able to...
As it's rotating.
Within 2 inches, get them off balance.
There you go.
Can you do a roll?
Huge.
Yeah,
if you don't, otherwise
it's a minimum of 2 inches.
From your
you
knees.
Four,
but
yeah.
Minimum.
Too much.
Yeah, we have a difference.
So now 2 inches, right? Now what?
Yeah.
Now it's too much. He's just dragging him. He's walking, right? So too much is too much.
Okay.
2 inches is it.
Problem with it. One problem with it
you look for
is
three.
You're rolling across
okay,
your
so
back.
If I got them
this
here,
way,
like
if there's a boulder there,
balance,
what happens?
Three
seven
points.
Vertebrae.
I got one here, which
well,
is
careful.
Right.
I got
okay.
one here with
the So what we do is this. We have a long roll. We have a short roll. Short means controlling. So short means I'm shooting and I'm moving. And this one,
close.
Do it in slow motion together.
Okay.
From
right?
To my head.
Okay.
You're back here.
So what you're going to be doing is this.
It'll get counted.
You're kind of almost like you're diving
now
into the ground, right?
But I can just
one arm stays as a support, while the other one starts rotating and creating a rotational momentum around this drive shaft.
Yeah, you're wasting your strength.
That's going to take the momentum onto the shoulder, so the head's going
to
look the other way. Okay, and then you're going
to
go
to
shoulder
to
shoulder, and then straight down the back.
Come over here. Now,
how was that?
Much.
Did it feel shoulder, shoulder, down the back? Right. So what are we eliminating?
So that's why
the possible spinal injury. Okay. So go ahead and do that in a little bit faster motion. Again.
Yes.
Okay.
You can do it from.
Yep.
Yeah, you know, usually it's not, you know, unless you want to go in the,
nice.
The
you do it from standing
like
up?
Mr. Gumby and they just do this. I mean, that's a start
cool.
for something
very nice.
Else.
Very
you
soft.
Do this.
Mm-hmm. If he's resisting,
no,
he's pulling back.
We're ready.
Pull back, right?
Yeah,
he's pulling back.
And then vice
now he's
versa.
Going that way, right?
Yeah.
If I got him this way and he pulled back, he's pulling back. And
Jimmy's got him covered. Okay, I drop you, you drop me.
But that in itself isn't going to get the person down. There's going to be another move after that, but you're just setting it up.
Right. So if you're moving the hips, there has to be a fulcrum point.
Out of anything that we did.
You gotta see the X's here.
Anything?
Anything.
So if I'm moving that hip, there's another point where I'm moving that hip. I'm moving this hip here, there's a reason why I'm doing that. Right? If I'm pushing it forward, and then the back, you're switching, right? There's a big stick in the middle.
Slowly as possible to give you an opportunity to relax. There's a number of
you know what the issue is? You're shorter. So you're trying to do it like a move.
I end up here.
Like, yes, right here. I can reach over here and then stand and move and keep it locked, right? Versus what if I'm shorter? I can't reach. Can I go over here?
Okay.
Yeah.
So,
bring it in closer, because you can't reach.
Look at this. Now you want to go up, because I'm just moving an inch over here.
Well, I was telling her she can go here along the axis. Here it's going to take more power.
It's
here.
The consciously
you can do all kinds of
things.
That's right. That's right. Now here we're going to do the first fall. We have to bring you here.
Somebody who's just laying down there, proved to be a threat.
Okay. So you face your fears and then go away, right?
Don't worry, and you can clean yourself afterwards. Okay. You're not cleaning yourself a lot.
It's like
so
everything's still
there. Yeah, well, it's
still alive.
Yeah,
full alive.
So I'll tell you something all the time.
Yeah. And besides, you'll see it on the ground.
That is absolutely, I don't like it, but it's got to be done because all of a sudden when the feet leave the ground, everything's like, you totally lose awareness of anything and everything.
Breathe out.
It's good with this room. I went halfway.
Yeah, but you see, when she's here and someone does the technique, she doesn't twist her leg. Her leg doesn't go off.
She doesn't have time to think.
Oh, just my leg.
This breathing is essential. And then it's not.
Would that be similar?
That much breathing. And way early. It takes a lot of time to get that air out of your system. So you got to start breathing right away.
Here?
Not
just
after you fall, but before you fall.
Deflate the balloon completely.
That's all that was left.
Okay. So now
you could have put a little bit of a feather on me and I would have dropped
this
back.
Now you're helping me. I mean, that wasn't supposed to be to make you fall.
Sorry.
It's okay.
I was trying to get ahead of myself.
Well, you're imagining what was going to happen. You're saving me. Okay, now.
Because I'm trying to like keep in mind, breathe out.
Okay, now I got this hand, or this hand card is okay, but now we're going to do
it. Takes a little bit more.
Here. And I don't need to touch your. So go along with it. Go along.
That kind of like freaks me out.
Go along with it. Now we're doing it slowly. Go along.
Ooh. Breathe out now.
Go along with it.
Breathe out first.
And it's a waltz falling to the hand.
Everyone's falls. So we still have the, from the front, we also have, the same X that we were, talking about before, the X in the back, there's also the X in the front.
If you're doing that, it doesn't do much, right?
You just rotate.
I'm going to have that first.
So if I'm
pushing here and I bring this,
okay, you just twist.
Step back and walk around. Look.
But that in itself isn't going to bring you down.
No, it'll put you off balance, though.
It'll put you off balance for the next move.
It delivers levers.
Why you're not going to go that way.
What am I pushing into right here?
Oh, the other.
I'm not going that way. Am I going that way? And that's it.
Okay. Now,
could I use this?
Now I'm arriving to what's behind you.
Okay.
And we were talking about the face.
We got the big stick. The biggest stick of
it's
all.
It's the same thing.
It's true.
Well, no, yeah.
What do you use? You use the hip? You use
just the head first before we. So
D3.
Here is one of them. And it really just seems. Where's the leg at?
That's more of a power level, right? It's going from a big part to a small part. Mm-hmm. You can also do the feet up, just the head, right?
It was just balanced me initially.
So
then
straight
you pick me up, and then you balance me
right? Because you have a lever, right? Yeah, could hit the knee.
So it's
right.
One,
and that's more of a strength lever, right? And you got to push and pull at the same time, right?
Good.
See what happens?
And the reason why
the back
this
of the head
was because you
so
squatted.
Instead of, yeah.
And
yeah.
You squatted.
Okay. Yeah.
Same thing. So
that's
it
that's
why.
Because
so
you brought your
move, your hands
center of gravity
in that position, you don't know what to do. It could also go sideways, right? Right? So if they go sideways, like that,
lock.
See the difference?
Lock by your hip.
There's very little you can do with that.
It's not only, I mean, the nose is just something that's sticking out you can grab, but in reality, you can also feel like if your hand happens to be here, you get the same result.
Right?
So under the chin, you get the same result. You have more.
Which way can I go?
You get the top of the
forward.
Head.
Walk around.
With the top of the head, the same result.
Forward.
And also, of course, every time you rotate the head,
exactly.
The head only wants to go here. I mean,
right on the
edge.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
Is that?
Too much effort, but
all you needed to do.
You gotta have two pieces though, right?
Yes. So the back of the neck. That's
mm-hmm.
Right.
Otherwise, we're just smacking the head. Right? Without the other piece.
First,
it'll
be small.
But, you know, you
want to fight me?
Yes. Go and put head and neck, especially if you're shorter, it's not gonna work so well. So maybe you wanna go and put one on the head and one in the smallest back.
Mm-hmm. Or under the chin.
Mm-hmm.
See what happens. What reacts to the most?
Didn't grab it.
Neck.
Didn't grab it.
And then
grab the
here.
Heel.
Yeah.
Does it work better there? Or here?
That's
here because I'm shorter. Because
right.
Here I don't feel like anything.
Right.
I just feel like I'm trying to try it. It's going to be
so now, put your hand here. And now twist this chin. Like the other way.
Okay.
Don't get your
one
pull.
Right?
So like.
One is more effective than another. And it's like those teeter totters, those levers, the seesaw. So for someone that's your size against someone that's your size,
did I already
do
it?
What's earlier.
The teeter totter one, the general teeter totter.
Like
you have a one in the middle, and the teeter totter like this.
Okay. So
if we're going over here,
so
what do you see?
Back
here. Here, one point there. Where's your second point?
Here.
And or where else?
So
your
legs
balance
backwards here
in the mirror.
No,
I went was, I pushed
this
elbow out of the way.
So actually, that's the long way. If you keep it here, lower that.
You want that on my top.
Okay, so now you're shorter.
Yeah.
So where you are.
Good.
See this here? Pull that towards your waist.
Yep.
Up. There you go. You see how that works? Now do it again. Pull his head down. Up with the arm. Right?
Yep. It's pretty simple.
Grab
it. Do
yeah.
this.
Yeah, yeah. See how I have to take this down?
Yeah. You have to take this
down.
That's
the strongest
with one.
Fighter
that you can both of them together.
It's a lever. It's
sure
a lever. It's to move inside. It's a lever.
Yeah.
Right?
That you can
it's
fight.
A lever. If you can reach all the way, you got more leverage here, right?
Jimmy actually does
shorter,
that pretty good.
He's got like, to reach here. That's it.
Sometimes. Jimmy, can you give me a hand?
So, if
it's
shorter, I would have to.
Jimmy, can you give her a hand?
Oh, sure.
There we go.
Let's do this one.
He's trying to be gentle.
He's helpful.
Yeah.
It's a little bit. Guys are more. They're less flexible. They're more stringy.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
Oh. Want to feel like?
Do it again.
Sure.
Oh shit.
Yeah. My turn or your turn?
Right.
See? So you get a circular motion.
Mm-hmm.
Like a tabletop.
Okay. What do you have right there? Stop. Get back here.
Going crazy. I'm like scared of hurting you guys.
No,
no, no. We know how to fall.
Yeah.
Don't worry about
trying
to hurt. Nope.
Yeah.
So you got leg right there. You're going around
yeah,
it.
Yeah, he just said.
All right. Around it.
So
keep going.
Let's see what happens with some of these speed levers, right?
This was the strength lever,
right?
Right? Right.
Yeah.
So, remember now?
What was the
speed lever?
Mm-hmm.
Just drop it like this, right? This one thumb, just drop them like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, smart. So normally I would have just...
Remember, it's straight up and down, not sideways.
And that's
sideways
work.
Doesn't work, right?
Perfect.
Sideways doesn't work. Straight up and down.
Because you've got a problem, you've dislocated
it. Yeah,
so
yeah.
Now, if you flip them around, lay them down on his face
and
then.
And let them go.
Well, whack.
Yeah,
you always
let
them to the ground.
And let
don't
go.
Try to help each other up.
And then hold it. Don't hold it.
Mm-hmm. There's a point of no return.
Okay. No way.
You let go at that point of no return. That's
if
why we look for these
confused,
those 2 inches.
To what it is, just say
2 inches there, right?
Don't tangle yourself up. There's
that point of no return,
you're
done.
Because
there's another person coming in.
Yeah, just walk around.
This is designed for multiple attackers.
See what you have.
And you'll see when we...
This is a weak point.
When we practice a lot,
right here is a weak point.
We'll have someone in the middle and everyone attacks at the same time.
Which way?
You're just dropping them. You don't have time to react. So if David's grabbing at me, right?
And that's it.
Right? So
easy, right?
Just grab whatever. Right, so he's grabbing, he's coming down, and that dude's coming, he's grabbing down, and you're throwing him, right? I'm grabbing David. He drops me.
Oh,
crap.
He's got another person coming at him.
Good job.
So try some more speed levers. Remember, maybe two hands, right?
Yeah,
not the one that's sore.
Yeah, I'm just going to keep the thumb in.
Yeah, so.
You need a thumb.
Sorry.
All right. Try the other hand.
All right. And then the
yep.
Is that one?
Yep. You didn't take me to the your
oh.
side. You have to move. You have to move me a little bit to you. You also have to get closer.
So. No.
On top, and your elbow pointing right through here.
Got more speed levers. Remember the ankle, those tiny little speed levers, right?
It's different.
Yeah.
Tiny little levers that affect.
That's fine.
Imagine. There you go. Exactly. Good job. Yeah, you're anchoring right behind there. A little smug thing, right?
And
then
you
set
your line
where
it's
like,
that one's not as effective.
Thank you.
The
from the outside?
Try to always come from the outside, yeah. All right. All right, now you're working on her, same thing. Speed levers.
Okay. So, I come here.
I feel like I put a lot of effort into that.
Breathe out. You don't have a heavy impact if you breathe out.
And same one, but on the other side.
Outside.
Okay. Face her. Face her.
And face you.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Right.
So here, same leg.
Yep. Here.
Yeah,
be facing her though. Not down the side. Back in the shin, right?
Yeah. There you go.
Breathe out.
You don't want to fall down?
Kind of,
don't fall down.
Yeah, that kind of freaked me out a little.
Okay. It's weird. I know it's weird. Alright, now the hands. Speed levers. Okay. You just relax. You just relax. We're not resisting or reacting in any way.
Yeah,
when you're the,
yeah,
you just when you're the receiver. Yeah. The attacker, just usually we're like the mannequin where you just try to relax. And we've worked on it later in the resisting thing, but right for now we just learn to make it.
Still afraid of falling, are you?
Okay. So let's have this.
Oh, I'm gonna fall.
So, and the hand, and drag her back, try that. Speed lever. Speed lever.
That one.
Your waist straight up and down.
Okay. So
lever, yep.
You want to use this
one? Well, it's actually good that you're going back and forth
with the whole hand.
In such a way that is.
If you see the triangle, which needs to form like this, and the triangle if it were to go back.
Does that make sense?
If this is like triangle, right? If this gets pushed, so as you're going this way, just rotate it right back.
Yeah,
it's a little strength.
Not gonna do much.
The back locks in.
I thought about falling.
Don't think about it. You've got to breathe out. Okay? Now, let's work on this where there's what we call static. So, kinetic is movement, right?
Yeah.
Static is gravity.
Okay.
So, what would you do? Look for three places where you
would. I would put my.
You have an anchor and a pivot. Right here. If I put my hand here, what would you do?
Here.
You want to get a nice pivot point there, right? Now you look for an anchor. There's one place. Look for two more.
Here.
Okay, twist the hand around. There you go. Now pull down.
No problem.
See how that works?
That's why we do the rolls and stuff so that we know how to fall.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of
the angles.
Drag this side, what would you do? There you go, you got an anchor. Yeah.
Okay.
What would you do? Squat.
Just
make sure. Do that trade-off one-on-one with status. Throat, grab his arm, pull the gun, shoulder.
From here?
Grab.
Okay.
This should have been eight. Sure, because you're already. You
what's
felt the energy as you already had
on the third.
It's already coming
one,
in.
Two. Hold on. Show me three. Where's one?
Yeah.
One thing you would do. That's one. Okay, now start over. What's the second one?
Same here.
Uh-huh.
What did I just?
Two. What's the third one?
Shift the balance.
Third one.
Three. One long stick. And then push out.
And you drop on the third.
Nope.
All right.
We'll do
that.
And if I wanted to hurt you, I would
don't
fall away to the ground, busted that hand.
That's
one. That's one, do three. Show me three.
Okay.
And drop on the third.
Okay, like, gotcha. Either one.
No, just, okay. I want you to look for
that move.
Okay.
Is this easier than going for moves?
One thing you do, start over,
right.
Two.
Because you're starting to visualize all these different in-betweeners, right? And the moves as well.
Right. There you go. Now you switch.
Okay.
So, as we're going up here.
Okay, what's the first thing you do?
Again, what
at that point, right? And you take the knocks out, it's like 2 inches, right?
That's it.
You just step back just a little bit.
Just more power.
That's it. See him move 2 inches?
Actually, you don't even have to step back.
Exactly. Or into the knee.
That's even less.
See that though? 2 inches? There's one.
It's into the knee. It's a bigger stick.
Two? Where's the third?
May need to go again.
No, but,
but it's a bigger step. Like I said, the guys were not quite so squirrely.
I'm here, and it's closer for me to lose my balance backwards than to move forward, because I could always go like this, right? So here,
or if you're pretty low, you need to disbalance. You need to disbalance. You need to disbalance.
See how effective that is?
No, because you're pushing it absolutely too high, and you're pushing it almost against my leg, against this one. If you were pushing over here that way, then it would have worked.
One, there's two.
Just like.
Where's the third?
I'll see you later.
The third. Yep. Breathe out. Good job. Good job. Got to breathe out.
So from below,
breathing
if
out
I was
huge,
over here.
Huge. Here, do this. I like this. Big breath.
Is that 11?
Make a squat.
Yeah.
Without breathing out.
Oh, that's great.
You do it with me. Big breath. Make a squat without breathing out.
What did you do here?
You just
shoot right there. Oh, hold it.
Okay. Now, do this. Big breath. Now breathe out while you're squatting.
It goes the other way, too.
See, you only want to fall down right there, right? You want to sit. Huge difference. You got to breathe it out.
The other way.
When you
take
breathe everything out, then your internal organs kind of like.
So if I was to go this way, you feeling how that's shifting?
Body is full of air, then it's not flexible.
It also goes the other way.
The balloon is full. The balloon is pushing on everything.
See that stick with the good point,
right? And it's also pushing on the muscles
on the vehicle.
So when those muscles hit the ground, they hurt.
Because
they're tense. They're holding your pain. Right? Relax. Relax. It's all about being relaxed. You'll see that there's no stance. We don't have a stance, right?
It's not boxing.
There's no stance going on here, right? There's none of this that you see like some of the martial arts. None of this. It's relaxed. It's for multiple reasons. It's not just so that you don't get hurt.
Left
it's very mind-blowing to someone who maybe is confrontational to you. If they're like, come on, right?
Here.
And you're just standing there.
Jimmy, you guys covered
big
the
difference. Big
ears?
Yeah.
But you can't go like this. Hey, I don't want any trouble. You know, you already have your hands kind of in front of you.
Yeah, you were there. Relax.
I'm cool.
Yeah. Just relax, you know, for non-confrontation. If you don't want to fight, if we have to, we know that they won't have a choice because you've learned how to react in certain ways. Like he was saying about driving a car. Instinct, car slams on its brakes in front of you. You know immediately to hit the gas and downshift, right? You don't have to think, oh, I need to do this and I need to do that. I got to do this. Now I got to start over. Do over, right? No, we don't have time for that, right? So you don't want to have to think about it. And we can train our muscles to do everything for us so that we don't have to think about it. And you have that edge, which is huge. Because you have the other martial arts guy who's trying to plan a move. Okay, so they told me that I got to punch, and I got an uppercut, and then I do a kick, and then, I didn't work out, so then they start over again, right? So then you have this, back and forth, where when someone comes at you, and they grab you, I'm going to pull a move, right? And you just drop them to the ground, game over.
So what's in here, right?
It's not a fight anymore.
Which one of
them? There's another person coming at you, and you can react to them immediately, but your body's doing it for you.
We'll practice a lot with this, too.
Blindfold. So when someone's attacking you blindfold, this is a really good indication where your body does it for you. Yep. So your body becomes a weapon, not your mind.
If I go over here.
You know, it's kind of like when you first start to drive, you know, all your attention's on everything, and you're concentrating on driving. The first month of your driving, oh my God, I can't concentrate. Just can't move. I can't, no music, no this. Afterwards, after you do it for a while, you know, you listen to music,
like
you look out the window, you talk to your friend, you eat at the same time, you talk on the phone, and you do everything, you do 10 things, because now, you know, you made driving into a routine that you don't have to think about.
My first year, and then drop.
So those guys already have, all the fighting already built down into something that they don't even have to concentrate.
and pulling down, you're doing exactly that.
You can eat well.
Enjoying my bait. Yeah. Are we doing this?
By the way, did you see that if you're going the British out, Medical Journal came out and said that the vapes are actually a lot healthier.
So what you want to do is
probably have cases every meal.
No, no, they said
Jimmy, I'm going to work on geometry a little bit. You cover any of that yet?
No, we can still work on that together if you want.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
All right, let's
do it, Mikey.
Okay, me and Jimmy are going to demonstrate first. So grab a reverse stick. Or actually, anybody want to take a break? Y'all feel break? Break? Smoke? Smoke if you got them. I'm going to take one. Jimmy?
Break?
No. Okay. I'm going to take a smoke and
I'm David.